Investigation of a Coma During Brain Death Examination by Dr. David K. Urion.
The first thing we'll do is examine the patient and see that, in point of fact, as we look up here, his heart rate is 110. His blood pressure is 89 to 85 over the 50s, and his oxygenation is at 100% by pulse oximeter. Thus, all of the metabolic conditions, and his temperature has also been demonstrated to be above 36 degrees, would be present so that we can proceed with this examination. And you'll have to take our word for it that we've interrogated the chart and made certain that there is no explanatory findings of sedating medications, neuromuscular blocking agents, or things of that nature. The first thing we would do is to see if we can discern any response from the patient at all. We'd say, hello, 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 young man. In the absence of that, we'd then see if more vigorous stimulation would provoke any kind of response from him at all. In the presence of decorticate or decerebrate posturing, we know then that parts of the nervous system are still intact and therefore the diagnosis of brain death can't be made. It's important to remember, however, that there are certain automatic responses that don't constitute anything from the brain itself. For example, a so-called triple flexion response, flexion at hip, knee, and ankle, is an involuntary spinal response and doesn't constitute any kind of a meaningful response from the brain itself. And so in this instance, the first thing we would do is a moderately painful stimulus, for example, here at the toes. Any of a number of things can be used to generate a painful stimulus. You can put your reflex hammer in between the toes, holding onto them and twisting like this. We then look to see if there's any autonomic response, and we see that while I'm doing this, his heart rate is completely invariant and making no change at all. Finally, we'd lift back his eyelids, and we'd look to see if there's any pupillary response to this at all. Again, an autonomic nervous system change that might suggest intactness of certain parts of the thalamocortical connections, and in this instance, there's none.
Painful toe stimulus. A normal response to the application of a painful stimulus to the toes is that the patient should withdraw his or her foot as seen here. An abnormal response is when a patient does not withdraw his or her foot as demonstrated here, nor does he or she demonstrate any autonomic or pupillary response to the stimulus.
Similarly, we can grab the nail bed and squeeze here, again, seeing if there's any kind of pupillary response in our patient. And again, looking for any kind of autonomic nervous system response or involuntary or voluntary motor response. And again, we see none.
Painful nail bed stimulus. A normal response to the application of strong pressure to any of the nail beds will be that the patient should withdraw his or her hand as seen here. An abnormal response is when a patient does not withdraw his or her hand, nor does he or she demonstrate any autonomic or pupillary response to the stimulus.